This is Fame, and we have another full house vacuum cleaning video. Today I'll be vacuuming a small modular home. The living room will be cleaned itself as far as shampooed using the very low moisture process. This place has three bedrooms, which is, this is bedroom number one, bedroom number two, and across the way, the master bedroom. But as I was walking around, I saw a few goodies that'll be good for everybody. Like in the corners, we have a lot of dust and dirt, which makes for some good, crunchy vacuuming. And I believe it's like that in the other rooms, and including this living room over here. And these corners will be vacuumed off camera using the Sanitaire Mighty Mite. Once again, on Amazon, I think I saw one on eBay a few days ago, roughly $100. Great buy. Very ubiquitous, classic machine. It does a job. And same goes for this machine over here that I'll be using today. Which I believe the most popular and most common Sanitaire upright of the classic series, the SC886 model. I mean, you've seen it in every school, every business building, they're just everywhere. And I mean, I grew up with them, and they're easy to work on. I mean, their parts are so accessible. I mean, all Sanitaire parts are accessible, but I mean, these bad boys, I mean, high CFM, I mean, tough, just great machines. And so this model, I would call it like a Type E, because I pretty much had all those parts and specs for Type E from like roughly the mid 90s to like, or mid 2000s. I think 2007 was the last year Sanitaire went with a Eureka look before they swapped over to Electrolux. So like I said, like the beige handle, beige cord, beige hooks, you know, the classic dial-in app, the Sanitaire with the yin yang. I added a magnet bar. It's an OEM bag, but it's not the new one. It's not the older one from that era. And on the under it, as any SC886, fiber groomer 2, and I added these magnets. And these are pretty cool because, let's say any metal comes from under it and it misses and it kicks back, these magnets will pick it up. And they're easy to clean because you just pop them off. And I can push everything off into a trash bin, snap it back on, and I'm good to go. But yeah, I mean, this is a ground up built machine. I mean, I used a bunch of pieces from, like, I think a SC684 I found on eBay for parts, and I just used a lot of the hardware, like, you know, bolts, screws, and etc. So in a few, we'll be running this bad boy. Oh, it also has the 8-amp Sanitaire motor. I think one of the last ones that Eureka was starting to run before they swapped over to the I guess the more commonplace plastic top motor. So anyhow, yeah, so that's what's running on the inside. So once again, classic Sanitaire sound. And we'll be filming some good vacuum footage shortly. Stay tuned. So I'm going to pause really quick because I have a few wood pellets to pick up, and I'm not going to let it kick the belt off its roller, so I'll be right back. All right, pardon the interruption. Thank you. So one major thing I noticed, and I hope I say his name right because he shouted me out. I know his real name, but I'm not going to do that over YouTube. KGV5 Vacuums. He did a great video regarding the leakage of sanitaires in this section right around here. And I'm going to try to see if I can find a more permanent solution to try to prevent the shakeout bags from leaking in such a way. And I think mostly it's because of the design. Like you mentioned, the bottom, it's like a divot or something, and it's not really sitting as straight as it should. But the correction he made drastically reduced any of the leakage. I mean, he almost had little to nothing there after he made his retrofit. And on the bottom, I noticed a little earlier, it's not on perfectly, but right there in the corner, I had to fix the seal, and that's really fun. I really didn't catch anything. Oh, I caught one little thing right here. Also, it did its job. I just probably caught everything else on the bottom. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, and I'm going to probably turn this on just so I can pick up a lot of this residual trash right here. And that's a wrap. I'll probably do a bag dump later in the evening because I don't have the facility to necessarily to do it comfortably or without a lot of wind blowing. So really quick. So anyhow, overall, I'm impressed with my own work. Ground up building of another sanitaire vacuum, SC886. I guess I call it Type E model because it fits those specs from like that 90s or early 2000s era. And later on tonight, we'll knock out that bag dump for you all. So I just arrived home maybe about 20, 30 minutes ago, and I'm about to do a quick bag dump from that job earlier. Again, Sanitaire SC886. Real quick, I always see videos about how people, you know, dump these shakeout bags, pulling this clip unnecessarily. See, this clip is made out of plastic, and over time they can weaken and break. And I understand I have belts around, you know, the spring, but I'm not accessing the belts frequently as often as I bagged up. So I just feel like over time, you know, they start wearing, this area starts to wear a tear, and then that's why you'll see some of these machines look like junk with duct tape around them, because individuals keep just pulling and yanking unnecessarily. It's very easy just to grab and pull across, which I did right there, and honestly roll the machine to your dustbin or your trash bin. And that way you don't have to worry about carrying dust all over the place. But anyhow, here we go, the bag dump. And lastly, I usually blow these machines out with a leaf blower, low setting, just to get all the residual dirt out. You know, it's not super clean, but it's clean enough. I can get
Ah, it's my fault, right?
Same goes with the unit itself. And that's a wrap. Took my machine, blew it off using a leaf blower. Voila. I mean, I can superficially dust it with a microfiber, but it's more or less ready to go, at least presentable. Once again, appreciate you watching my video. More to come in the future. I have a couple of gigs tomorrow, but I'm not gonna be in a position to take more footage, but perhaps this weekend I'd have another small gig, so maybe the SC888 or something like that, or the 886 again.